Hello students, in this session I am going to discuss another method for the preparation of amines. In the previous video we have already discussed the different method for the preparation of amines from amylolysis of alkyl halide and the reduction of amine. Today I am going to discuss the reduction of nitro compound. As we know, either aliphatic or aromatic nitro compound, it is the nitro benzene. We can take aliphatic nitro compound also, and when the reducing agent palladium, platinum, nickel or sodium amalgam in ethanol or we use in C2H5OH is used as a solvent in which hydrogen gas given by this species and the nitro compound directly converted into amine. So remember this, this reducing agent reduce the nitro compound, and nitro compound after reduction converted into, this is called the aniline, this is the nitro compound. And this reducing agent is used in which solvent we take ethanol as a solvent. We have option to use SNHCl or FeHCl for the this reducing agent is also used to reduce nitro into aniline. For example, if we take CH3NO2, this is the nitromethane, and by using palladium, platinum, nickel gives H2 gas, and ethanol used as a solvent. So by using this reducing agent, this nitro compound convert into amine. This is methyl amine. So SN plus HCl and FeHCl used, in fact it is the best method when we convert nitro to amine by using Fe plus HCl. This is most convenient reducing agent used to convert nitro to aniline. Iron is a, we use scrap of iron use, and it is the low quality of scrap iron, so it is the cheapest method and best method to use FeHCl or SN plus HCl. Both of them, this reducing agent mostly used to convert nitro to aniline. So you students, learn properly for the conversion point of view how nitro compounds get converted into aniline, either aliphatic or aromatic. So nitrobenzene, when treated with this reducing agent palladium, platinum, nickel in ethanol as a solvent, we know that this reducing agent provide hydrogen gas and nitro compound get converted into aniline, direct method. And apart from this, we also use SNHCl and FeHCl for the reduction of nitro to aniline. And we prefer to use Fe plus HCl over the SnHCl because here we use the scrap of iron, which is the cheapest or conveniently low quality of iron is used. So it is the cheapest method for using Fe plus HCl. Now we discuss the another method, which is named reaction, that is called the Gabriel thalamide synthesis. It is the named reaction in which we use thalamide for the preparation of amines. This method is only 1 degree alkyl amine, only for 1 degree alkyl amine. This method we can prepare only 1 degree alkyl amine. We can't prepare aryl amine by this method, because as we know, in aryl amine no nucleophilic substitution takes place. We have already read in haloarenes chapter, in aryl halide no nucleophilic substitution takes place because during resonance here is the double bond form, and so that lot of energy required to break this bond. So this compound does not favor the nucleophilic substitution. So by this method, Miss Gabriel thalamide synthesis is only for the preparation of 1 degree alkyl amine. So at first, how thalamide formed? We all know about this compound. This is known as benzene 1,2 dicarbolic acid, and it is commonly known as thalic acid. And it is benzene 1,2 dicarbolic acid, it is the common name of this compound is thalic acid. When this thalic acid treated with ammonia, the formation of thalamide takes place. This is known as thalamide. And when this compound is strongly heated, removal of NH3 takes place, NH2 and one hydrogen from air. So the formation of compound, which is known as C double bond O, C double bond O, and here N and H. This is known as thalamide. So students, at first we should know about how thalamide formed and what will the structure of thalamide, how it is prepared, from which it is prepared. So it is prepared from thalic acid. When thalic acid treated with ammonia, at first thalamide form, and after strong heating, removal of one molecule of NH3, so that we get thalamide. And here we use thalamide synthesis, and the name of scientist is Gabriel. So at first we write down the reaction. When thalamide treated with पोटेशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड और सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड एट फर्स्ट, इन सेकेंड में अल्काइल हैलाइड यूज्ड एंड इन थर्ड वाटर विल बी यूज्ड एंड अल्काइल हैलाइड इन्वॉल्व इन SN रिएक्शन सब्स्टिट्यूशन न्यूक्लियोफिलिक रिएक्शन सो दैट फॉर्मेशन ऑफ 1 degree amine apart from the salts of halamide form sodium salts of these compounds form. This is the main product. So for preparing 1 degree amine we use Gabriel thalamide synthesis. So see how this reaction goes and what are the mechanisms involved. Try to understand. At first, thalamide treated with base because there is a acidic hydrogen. We know that metal acquire positive and OH ion acquire negative. And here is the bond between N and hydrogen. Nitrogen is more electronegative than hydrogen, so this bond shifted towards the nitrogen and this OH ion gives their electron to the hydrogen so that removal of H2O takes place. Then what happens? See the intermediate formed. C double bond O, C double bond O, and here nitrogen acquire negative charge and potassium acquire positive charge. So the formation of potassium salts of thalamide. Here the alkyl halide comes and nucleophilic substitution takes place in this step. We know that halogen more electronegative, so it takes electron and acquire negative charge and carbon acquire positive charge. So here nitrogen acquire negative charge so that we can alkyl attach with nitrogen and halogen attached with potassium. So the formation of, write down the compound, C double bond O, C double bond O and N and R, and the removal of KX takes place. Removal of K and X takes place. This compound when treated with potassium hydroxide, this is OH ion and this is positive potassium ion. See what happens. When this pi electron shifted towards the oxygen and the carbon becomes electron deficient, so OH ion gives the electron to the carbon. When this electron come back their position, so the removal of bond, or we can say that bond break between the carbon and nitrogen. Again I am explaining, when the pi electron shifted towards the oxygen, simultaneously OH ion gives the electron to the carbon because it becomes electron deficient. When this electron come back towards their position, so the removal of or breaking of bond takes place between carbon and nitrogen. So write down the compounds formed. C double bond O and here OH attached, and C double bond O, N and R, and R. Nitrogen by taking electron, so it get negative charge. What happens? See here. Hydrogen, this hydrogen is acidic hydrogen, so hydrogen transfer takes place. Because this oxygen is resonance stabilized, so it can easily lose hydrogen. So this hydrogen comes towards the nitrogen. We can write here H plus means H ion transfer. So by transfer of H ion, oxygen acquired negative charge. So simply I am trying to explain the mechanism so that we can easily understand the reaction, but not need of this mechanism to write in the examination NHR. So student, this compound again we treated with potassium hydroxide, KOH ion. This is negative and this is positive. Same things will be happen here. When this same things will be happen here. So when this electron come towards the oxygen, this OH ion gives the electron to the carbon, and then it come back towards their position, removal of means breaking of bond takes place between carbon and nitrogen. Then what happens? See here. C double bond O and O negative. We can write potassium positive also because it is present in the solution. So here carbon double bond oxygen and OH, and removal of this compound RNH and H, a negative charge present on the nitrogen because it takes the electron between the carbon and the nitrogen. Here again proton transfer takes place, proton transfer. These protons taken by nitrogen, so the formation of RNH2 takes place and formation of KOK comes here. So the formation of C double bond O negative, K positive, and here C double bond O, and in this way we can prepare 1 degree amine. So see here students, this is the thalamide. At first potassium hydroxide or base is used to remove the hydrogen. So nitrogen takes the electron towards itself, and this H plus is stabilized by OH ion. OH ion gives the electrons, and the removal of H2O takes place in this reaction. Now in the second reaction, nucleophilic substitution takes place. We can say that here aryl halide not formed because aryl halide does not undergoes to nucleophilic substitution, so that here alkyl halide is used. When nucleophilic substitution takes place, the formation of this intermediate compound takes place, and this intermediate compound treated with potassium hydroxide. Once this carbon oxygen double bond play an important role to accommodate the OH ion and break the bond between the carbon and nitrogen, and when OH ion, we know that OH ion is good releasing of H plus, it easily gives H ion to the nitrogen because it is the resonance stabilized compound. In this way, H ion transfer, so the formation of this intermediate takes place. Again, potassium hydroxide play a same role, OH ion given to the carbon, and the removal of NHR takes place. And here is H plus ion, which is easily given by this compound. We know that this is the resonance stabilized, so it can easily give the H plus ion, and negative charge present on the nitrogen, which easily accept H plus ion and get converted into RnH2 and the sodium salts. So this is the Gabriel thalamide synthesis. By this method, we can prepare only one degree alkyl amine. Aryl amine do not prepare by this method. So demerits and merit both learn how this reaction proceed. Write twice times and learn. Now our next name reaction is Hofmann's bromamide degradation reaction. As the name is clear, the product formed has one carbon less than the original substrate. For this, we use amide with bromine in basic medium, either sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. The formation of primary amine takes place with the byproduct Na2CO3, sodium bromide, and water. Here is this group is removed in the form of carbonate. So this is the best method for the preparation of amine also. Here, remember it, the amine form has one carbon less than the original substrate. This is the amide. For example, if we take CH3CONH2, the name of this compound is ethanamide. And when this ethanamide treated with bromine in presence of basic medium, the product form has one carbon less than, see here, here is the two carbons, and the product have only one carbon. This is the methyl amide with the byproduct Na2CO3 plus H2O plus sodium bromide. This reaction help in conversion of, when we try to reduce the number of carbon from the substrate to the product. So this method is used to reduce the number of carbon. Here is the two carbon and here is the one carbon. So write down the point, amine formed by this method, 1 degree amine, this method has one carbon less than the reactant. Amine formed, 1 degree amine formed has one carbon less than the reactant. And one thing more, in this reaction only one unit of bromine is used. So no, I am not going to explain the mechanism of this reaction. So simply, this reaction is given in your NCERT book. So learn it properly. The main thing is there to remember, when the Hofmann's bromamide degradation reaction used to prepare the amine form has one carbon less than the original reactant, because in the reactant number of carbon whatever the number of carbon, the product have one carbon less. So this is the another named reaction. Learn it properly. In the next video, we will discuss the next property, physical property, and another property we will discuss.